over 7 million people will use some type of orthotic device by 2020. So if you think of anything that needs to be supported, simple foot, if you have foot pain, back braces are very common. Many people have carpal tunnel, and positioning can help relieve the strain on the carpal tunnel.
What we're trying to do is to create a process that uses a 3D printing technique that prints these orthoses in a layer by layer manner and can do so in a custom way, and then eventually create a process that connects the orthotist to the patient, maybe without even the patient having to either come in or only having to come in once. We're using a new type of infill pattern that uses a wave to infill the interior of our orthoses. And this wave just creates a continuous infill pattern that increases machine efficiency, allows us to print parts very quickly.
Clinicians will scan the data of a person as the starting point to create the geometry. Then the information is processed through a cyber or cloud-based software to modify the shape and create the tool path for the 3D printer. The 3D printer then produces this assisted device. Then the patient will be able to try and evaluate this assisted device.
So some of the patients already don't wear their orthotics because of lack of comfort or lack of fit, or because they don't have the chance to come to a facility like this.
Not everyone has a large medical center or a skilled orthotist or prosthetist that lives near to them. And so that the idea of a one-day visit could be very attractive to people who currently are underserved. I see orthotics going the same place it's gone since the first orthosis was made centuries ago, which is someone seeing a problem and trying their best with the tools available to help that person out. I think as we as a field are always looking at other fields to see what other people are doing and how can we use or leverage that technology to improve the lives of the patients that we see. I think 3D printing is just going to open that up even more, because once our design tools are established and once we have a known output from the machine, and our creativity should just be that much more enhanced.
Say a linebacker hits the running back and they have a head-to-head collision. I'm very interested in what can cause injury to the brain as a result of an impact.